Hello, my dear students. I hope you all have drawn the diagram of important parallels in your notebook. So this is our next topic, longitudes or meridians. Now, meridians or longitudes are the imaginary lines which run from north to south on the earth. Actually, these are imaginary lines. No such line actually exists on the earth. They run from the north to south, and all the meridians are of same length. Like if we discussed about parallels, equator is the longest parallel, this is the equator, this is the longest parallel, and as we move in the northern hemisphere, because earth is spherical in shape, or we move in the southern hemisphere, the length of the parallels goes on decreasing. But when we talk about meridians, all the meridians start from the north pole and they reach to the south pole, and they are of equal length. The maximum distance between two meridians is at the equator. See here, the distance between two meridians is maximum at the equator, and as we move towards the pole, whether north pole or south pole, the distance goes on decreasing, and when we reach at the pole, the distance finishes, because all the meridians, they meet at the north pole or the south pole. Now, when we are drawing the diagram of model of earth globe and we are drawing parallels and meridians together, then parallel and meridians, they cut at the angle of 90 degree. When you will draw the diagram of grid, then you will understand it. A meridian and a parallel, they cut each other at the angle of 90 degree. Now after that, something more about the meridian, that the meridian, they do not run parallel to each other. Meridians are the longitudes. They do not run parallel to each other because they meet at the poles. Ends means poles. The maximum distance between two meridians is at the equator. I have already told you. Otherwise, the distance goes on decreasing. Now, we come to the topic, what is prime meridian? Okay. Now, again coming back to the diagram. In 1884, Greenwich, which is a place near London, this particular place was considered as a starting point for drawing the imaginary line of meridian, and this particular place was, or this particular line was known as a prime meridian. It is given in your next chapter. So prime meridian is our main meridian. The prime meridian cuts our earth in two hemispheres. One hemisphere is eastern hemisphere and the other hemisphere is western hemisphere. Okay, so total number of meridians we are having is 360. Total number of meridian is 360. 180 meridians are in eastern hemisphere and 180 meridians are in western hemisphere. Okay, and rest I told you, this is eastern hemisphere, western hemisphere, and 180 each is having. Now, okay, next thing is what is this international date line? International date line is the meridian of 180 degree E and 180 degree W. That means when we draw the meridians which we draw in the eastern side, in the eastern hemisphere, we write down E with them, and the meridians we write down E with them, and the meridians which we draw in the western hemisphere, we write down W with them. So this particular last meridian is, these are actually not two meridians, this is one meridian. The picture which you can see in your book is like half of the globe, like we cut an apple in two equal halves. So this is half of the globe. Actually, this line is 180 degree E and 180 degree W. So this particular meridian, the last meridian, is known as the international date line. So children, this is end of the topic. Now your diagram, your homework is that you can draw this particular diagram, the diagram which I am showing you. You can draw this particular diagram, and I think this diagram will be little tough for you. So draw this particular diagram in your rough notebook. Just practice the diagram of meridians of lines of latitude in your rough notebook. Don't draw anything in your fair notebook. Okay, just practice it. So bye children.